Wild pigs are an invasive species that costs the United States billions of dollars each year. They can attack at any time, both during the day and at night. In this video, we will show you how American farmers deal with wild boar attacks on farms. This herd of wild boars is preparing to attack the cow farm at night. These ranchers are prepared to protect the cows. They move very gently and gradually. They move towards the herd of cows. This wild boar herd is so large, ranchers and hunters have used electro-optical devices to assist in hunting to be able to clearly see each wild boar. Each time, the hunter will kill one wild boar. According to statistics from the U.S. Department of Agriculture, the number of wild boars hunted at night accounts for about 70% of the total number of wild boars hunted each year. Wild boars often travel in herds, destroying crops and stealing food. To prevent wild boar attacks, American farmers often use hunting methods at night. Wild boars often move in herds at night, making it easy for farmers to kill many pigs at the same time. Wild boars are often less alert at night, making it easier for farmers to approach and shoot them. During the day, they will spend most of their time resting and eating light food in the fields. You can see, the wild boars are running in the field. Hunters around this area gathered with hunting dogs to catch them. They let the hunting dogs search for wild boars, and then each hunter would stand in a different area to make sure no wild boars escape. One by one, they were brought down by the great hunting skills of the hunters. These are some of the farm areas that are attacked by wild boars in the herds. Now, we will come to a state that is heavily affected by wild boar attacks. In Texas, one of the states most heavily impacted by feral pigs, the economic and infrastructure consequences are very worrying. In 2022, feral pigs damaged more than 600,000 acres of crops, causing significant economic loss to farmers and agricultural workers. Crops such as rice, corn, and vegetables are often favorite targets of wild boars. The consequences of this sabotage go beyond loss of harvest and create significant financial pressure on farmers, causing instability in the agricultural sector. In addition, the wild boars have also caused damage to the infrastructure. They often dig in the ground to find food, damaging roads and bridges. Traffic systems and transportation infrastructure became susceptible to breakdowns and require large repair costs. This isn't just an issue of money, but also affects traffic safety and accessibility for the community. Wild boars not only cause economic and infrastructure damage, but also threaten the environment and human health. They are omnivorous and have a habit of destroying plants. This environmental destruction not only causes losses in agricultural productivity, but also reduces the sustainability of the ecological system. Wild boars have the ability to dig in the ground to find food, and this behavior can destroy natural ecosystems, change soil structure, and pollute the environment. This consequence can last a long time and affect the balance of the natural environment, causing long-term impacts on the ecosystem. Regarding health, wild boars carry many dangerous diseases that can infect humans and livestock. Some diseases caused by wild boars include African swine fever, African swine fever foot and mouth disease, brucellosis, leptospirosis, and salmonellosis. This disease transmission possesses a public health risk and requires strict prevention and control measures. Faced with harmful wild boars, American farmers have applied a number of measures to control them. Trapping and hunting are two traditional methods used to reduce wild boar numbers in the wild. In addition, enhancing farm security by building fences, using headlights, and hunting dogs is a way to prevent wild boars from entering. Surveillance systems using drones and GPS tracking devices have proven its effectiveness in tracking and locating wild boars. This gives researchers and control agencies the opportunity to identify the presence of wild boars earlier, thereby providing timely control measures. By combining technology and data, they can focus on areas with the highest wild boar densities and deploy control effectively. In addition to using technology, a rather unique natural solution is to grow plants with unpleasant flavors, such as chili peppers, lemongrass, and mint. Wild boars often stay away from these strongly flavored crops, so growing them can help protect important crops and farmers' food sources from encroaching animals. This is not only an effective way, but also a natural solution that does not harm the environment. Propagating and educating the community about the harmful effects of wild boars also plays an important role in the fight against this animal. Education programs can create awareness of the natural wild boar situation and motivate people to participate in control. It can also provide information on how to take safe and effective measures to protect food sources and habitats. In the fight against wild boars, collaboration is most important. Farmers, authorities, researchers, and communities all need to work closely together to ensure that control measures are deployed effectively. Together, we can protect the environment, economy, and people's health from invasive wild boars and keep it sustainable into the future. Feral swine are a serious threat to the economy and human health in the United States. The consequences of this invasion are very worrying and require the cooperation of all to deal with it. Faced with this threat, the U.S. needs to continue to research and deploy effective measures to ensure sustainability for the future. The area where you live has dealt with wild boar attacks on farms. Please comment all your thoughts and opinions down below in the comment sections. And for now, let's continue watching this video.